Well, thank you, and good morning. Thank you, Major Jordan, to the law enforcement officials serving us all across New Hampshire. Thank you to the families of our fallen heroes. Thank you as well to members of our congressional delegation, our executive counselors, state legislators, and all other elected officials who join us here today. Every time that we gather at this memorial to mark Law Enforcement Memorial Week, it is a solemn occasion. But this year it is particularly so. Last year at this time, I knew that we were lucky. We came together on this day without a new name to add to the walls of this hallowed memorial. I wish that were true once again. Instead, today we come together with a heavy pall of sorrow hanging over the state of New Hampshire as we mourn the loss of Brentwood Police Officer Steve Arkell, a man whose bravery and compassion represented the very best of law enforcement and the very best of humanity. 1 week ago today, Officer Arkell was a part-time officer and the only one on shift in the small town of Brentwood. That afternoon, Officer Arkell, who was also a carpenter, was with a lifelong friend mapping out a new railing on her deck so that her mom wouldn't fall. Just 20 minutes later, he got a call. And like all the brave souls whose names are etched into this memorial, and like the members of law enforcement gathered here today, Steve Arkell answered that call. He did his job, as he had so many times before. In doing so, he put his life at risk so that his fellow citizens could live in peace. And as we all know, he made the ultimate sacrifice. Steve Arkell, like the men and women before me and those we gather here to remember, was not just a police officer. He was a father, a husband, a coach, a neighbor, a friend, a brother, a son. He was a community leader, known to all as a kind and caring soul. And he was a builder, who with his own two hands strengthened so much of the town he loved. But when that call came, he set all of that aside, went into danger head first and alone, and lost his life in defense of our right to live our own life in safety. Then his fellow officer, Fremont Police Officer Derek Frenick, heroically followed behind through a hail of bullets, similarly risking his own life, but thankfully escaping harm. And more officers from surrounding communities also followed, many still with fresh memories of another call that they answered in April 2012 when we tragically lost Chief Michael Maloney. Each and every person whose name is on this memorial set a life aside for their fellow Granite Staters. And no matter how safe the shift seems, how slow the night has been, how small the town, each and every one of our law enforcement officers takes the very same risk every time she or he answers a call. Our law enforcement officials have been making sacrifices for their fellow Granite Staters for generations. Today we also honor two heroes from the 1880s, Officer George Prey and Sergeant Henry McAllister, whose names have been added since last year. When we lose an officer, it feels like a crack has opened beneath our feet, that the ground we walk upon has been broken in two. And that is because our law enforcement officers are the very foundation of our communities. Our first obligation as a society is to keep each other safe, to sustain a rule of law that truly recognizes and reinforces our equality and our common ground as Americans and Granite Staters. And you, the men and women of law enforcement, do that. You keep us safe simply because, and always because, we share a democracy. Time after time, you answer that call and put your lives on the line, never really knowing what is going to be on the other side of that door. None of what we have accomplished as a state or as a country would be possible without you. None of us could live our lives in peace and dignity without you. None of us could love or lead without you. And when we lose a member of law enforcement, we feel as though we have lost a piece of ourselves. So it is our shared responsibility to rely on one another, support each other, and do our best to fill in the hole left behind, to stay together and move through this pain. I have seen the people of Brentwood and the people of New Hampshire begin that healing process everywhere I have looked in the past week. From the signs expressing condolences to Steve Arkell's family and loved ones, to members of law enforcement from across the state offering support to his fellow officers, to the hundreds of friends, neighbors, and even complete strangers who gathered for a candlelight vigil to remember a hero taken from us far too soon. Nothing can fully assuage the pain of his family and of those who loved Officer Arkell, but we honor his courageous service through the strength of our sense of community, a community that he served to protect. And we honor all of those officers who have lost and those who continue to serve by recognizing their daily bravery and sacrifice. Steve, with all of our heart, the people of New Hampshire, thank you. We send our thoughts and our prayers to your wife, Heather, your daughters, Kim and Lauren, your parents, Marion and Tom, your brothers, Jeff and David, your fellow officers, and all those whose lives you have touched. And we miss you, as we miss all of the fallen heroes we honor here today. Thank you.